Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. The President and Chief Executive Officer of Scotia, Mr. Bowen, Dr. Colin Francis McGregor, Senior Justice of the Peace, and Executive Member of the Lay Magistrates Association of Jamaica in Kingston Chapter, Majors Stanley and Hazel Griffin, and other members of Divisional Command, members of my advisory board, territorial headquarters staff, members of the Salvation Army, Salvationists, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you all for being here this morning. And I especially want to thank JPS for cutting off the light so that you really can't hear me so well with these generators. But I intend to be brief this morning, so don't worry, you won't have to suffer with me for long. Last year I was here, I was master of ceremonies, and I think that they decided that this year they would shut me up and put me in this role instead. Nonetheless, this is one of my favorite events on the Salvation Army's calendar, and I'm so glad that you're here to participate and to be part of it as well, as we launched the Kettle for 2012. Now the Salvation Army Kettle carries a lot of symbolism, not only in Jamaica, but across the world. But I wonder sometimes, what do we think when we see the Salvation Army Kettle? What comes to mind really when you think of the Salvation Army? You see, many people only think that the Salvation Army comes out at Christmas time, that we're like very own church Santa Claus, and that really, once you see November, that's when you know that Christmas is around the corner. But ladies and gentlemen, as many of us here already know, and I think not enough of us know, the Salvation Army is so much more than that. But what do we really appreciate and what comes to mind when we see the kettle inside, outside of the schools? For some people, it's just a handy place to put loose change after they've been shot. For others, they're more cognizant of the spiritual nature and the mission Salvation Army carries. They recognize that it's an international organization founded on Christian principles. That's there to meet the social and spiritual needs of the various countries in which it's part. In Jamaica, the Salvation Army has been here for over 125 years. They celebrate it just this morning. And that's a phenomenal achievement for any institution, especially one that is not for profit. Not to say that our friends at Scotiabank are any less noble in their partnership with us, but the Salvation Army means something in Jamaica. And the fact that it's been here and been able to do so much for such a long time means something in Jamaica. And in particular, your contribution, your participation, your assistance from whichever form is what allows us, the Salvation Army, to do so much. To carry out many of the social programs, some of which you haven't even heard of. Is that what comes to mind though when you see the kettle? Let me tell you what comes to my mind when I see the kettle. I think of the passion and the dedication of the many volunteers, several of whom are ringing the bells every day for the Christmas season. I think of the dedication of our many sponsors, including Scotiabank, who year after year will consistently help us to meet our target. This year, our modest target is at $12 million. And I say modest because, unlike everything else, the target has not gone up. But we still count on you all to help us to reach that target because it means so much to us. I think of the never-ending need that the Salvation Army tries to meet each year, and not just at Christmas. Of course, the money that we collect at Christmas will last us a while to push forward some of those most essential programs. But it's just one of the many ways in which the Salvation Army needs assistance and reaches out. And that's part of the reason why the Salvation Army has an advisory board, of which I am presently chair. So that we can help to get the message out to people like you, the persons who are by the Salvation Army into their will. But I'm entirely sure that's something that they can do. Whoever thought of something like that? We are here to make sure that you know about the ways in which Salvation Army helps people in times of disasters, including recently with Hurricane Sandy and the effect that it continues to have in the northern parts of this island. The Salvation Army is the one that's there to help these persons, whatever the season, not just the Christmas. It's the Salvation Army that is one of the organizations leading the way to help restore persons who have been burnt out after fires. It's the Salvation Army that has children's homes, school for the blind, rehabilitation centers for those who are suffering from substance abuse. It's the Salvation Army which cares for old folks. It's the Salvation Army that is there to meet our social needs, our society.